So guys, we are going to talk about analytical functions with focus on windowing in this particular video. In the previous one, I had dropped some questions. I hope you had a chance to look at them. We will also solve them in this video. But before we go there, let's discuss the syntax and how it functions internally in our database and dataset. Once you get a hang of it, writing queries will become a piece of cake. And I have a request, please watch the video completely. These next few minutes will help you till the date you work on SQL. So here we have this dataset showing the number of cases for a disease for 3 cities every day. The syntax of analytic or analytical function may look very complicated in the diagrams, but it is actually very simple. On a high level, it just has 3 components: analytical function, the over keyword, and the over clause. First, you have the analytical function like max, min, rank, which can accept an argument. In 95% of the cases, you will use a column as an argument. Like in this case, we have specified max as the analytic function and cases as the argument. Then you write the over keyword, and after that you specify the over clause, which can contain your partition, order by, and window specification. Now everything that you see on this screen in square brackets is optional. That means our query would work just fine if we decide not to include them, which is why both these queries will work fine. The first query does not have any argument to the analytic function, while the second query does not have anything in the over clause. If we look at the output of this query, it will return the overall count of all cases listed in this table in front of every row. Here the total cases were 79, which is why you see that number. Now let's say we do not want to show the count for all cases, but we only want to see total cases that have happened only in that city. For that, we can use partition by in our over clause. Everything else remains the same. We just add partition by, which is the standard keyword, and columns using which we want to partition our data. Now, instead of summing the entire table, SQL will sum the cases based on the city. London had a total of 31, which is why we see 31 cases in front of it. So if we want our aggregate function to work individually on separate partition, we can use partition by clause for that. Now let's take a step forward and calculate the till date cases for the cities or the cumulative sum for the cities. For that, we just have to add an order by clause with date, and it will return a cumulative sum of cases. Basically, for this row in the background, SQL is checking which rows have cities as London and dates less than or equals to 15th January. After finding these rows, it is doing a sum of cases and showing them as output here. Till now, we have discussed analytic function over partition by and order by. But what if we only want to show the cases that occurred in the last 3 days respective to the date in the row, or we want to display all the cases that have happened in the city before the particular date? For example, here we want to see all cases that happened in London before 15th Jan, or all cases that have happened after 15th Jan. For all such scenarios, we have to declare an explicit window specification, and there are 4 commonly used windows or frames which are very straightforward. Let's see them with this row as our reference. So here, this will be our current row. Our dataset is ordered by date. Every row that comes before this row can be identified as rows preceding. Every row that comes after this row can be identified as rows following. For example, for our first row, we do not have any rows before it, so our preceding will be null, while everything that is coming after this row will be following. I hope this clarifies current row, preceding, and following. Now, if we want to calculate everything that comes on or before the current row, we can specify rows between unbounded preceding and current row as our window specification. it will calculate the analytic function of everything that comes on or before the current row. For example, for first row, we don't have anything prior to that, so we will get 6 as our sum. For the next row, we have a previous row with cases as 6, so we will get 19 as output, 6 plus 13 and so on. When you are calculating cumulative sum, this comes in really handy. Let's see what happens when we partition our data along with this window. Here the analytic or sum function simply operates in this window and then it resets itself. So for first row of London, it will only consider this row. For the second one, it will consider the first plus the second row. Now for the previous date, we have cases in New Delhi and New York as well, but we will not consider them because we have partitioned our dataset on the basis of city. Now if we want to select the recent rows in comparison to our current row, we can use n rows preceding and current row. For this case, we want to take the sum of 3 recent rows and current row. So we will write rows between 3 preceding and current row. If we do not want to include the current row, we can write rows between 3 preceding and 1 preceding. If we want to consider both preceding and following rows on the basis of our order by clause, then we can use rows between n preceding and n following. Finally, if we want to consider rows that comes after our first row, we can use rows between current row and unbounded following. If we want to exclude the current row, we can specify one following and unbounded following. Whenever you have to specify the window explicitly, order by and rows between are mandatory. And with that, you have these 5 options: unbounded, preceding, current row, following, n preceding or n following. When we are writing sum of sales over and a blank over by clause, SQL by default is considering the sum of all rows, which is equivalent to rows between unbounded preceding and unbounded following. If we want to take the cumulative sum, we can write sum of sales over order by sales date, which is also equivalent to rows between unbounded preceding and current row. If we want to take the cumulative sum and we want it to be partitioned by city, we can just write sum of sales over partition by city, order by sales date. Notice for these 3 scenarios, we did not have to specify the windows clause explicitly. SQL took care of it for us in the background. For the next scenario, if we want to ignore the current row, we have to specify rows between unbounded preceding and one preceding. This will ignore the current row. If we want to identify the sales for last few days and next few days, we can use rows between n preceding and n following. And if we want to calculate all sales that have happened on or after that date, we can use rows between current row and unbounded following. If we want to exclude the current row, we can write rows between one following and unbounded following. Now, if you understood the video till now, you should be able to solve 99% of the queries that require a window specification. Now, if you were not able to solve the queries earlier, go back to the previous video and try to solve them now. If you still need help, you can watch the next video for the solution of those queries.